Good day, doctors. Today we will discuss professional oral hygiene. Lecturer Markushova Natalia Vyacheslavna, Department of Pediatric Dentistry and Orthodontics. Objective: to study the stages and methods of professional oral hygiene. Lecture questions: types of dental plaque and their role in the pathogenetic of inflammatory periodontal diseases, stages of professional oral hygiene, professional teeth cleaning. The purpose of professional oral hygiene is prevention and treatment of diseases of the hard tissues, of the teeth and oral mucosa. Repeat: dental deposits. You remember that dental plaque can be divided into two groups. Dental deposits can be divided on two groups. Non-mineralized is pellicula, dental plaque, soft plaque, food residues, and mineralized, supragingival and subgingival. Pellicula: unstructured, acellular film composed of electrostatically linked salvia proteins. Functions: protective and attachment of microorganisms. Microorganisms attached to the pellicula after 6 hours. First, gram-positive cocci and actinomycetes. Second, the streptococci, villanella and filaments. Gradually, the thickness of the plaque increases due to the division of accumulation of bacteria. Poor oral hygiene leads to plaque formation. Dental plaque. Dental plaque consists of dense layer of bacteria that form its matrix. The initially formed plaque contains aerobic microorganisms. Over time, anaerobic flora begins to dominate. Tartar. Tartar in its structure is a mineralized dental plaque. It can be supragingival, salivary type, and subgingival. Serum type. The lighter the tartar, the less dense and hard it is. It forms faster and is deposited in greater quantities. Dark tartar is harder and denser, forms more slowly and in less quantity. All types of dental plaque are pathogenic, but to varying degrees. The main etiopathogenic factor of inflammatory periodontal diseases is dental plaque with a contain of colonies of microorganisms. The main etiological factors of inflammatory periodontal disease are: first, microorganisms and their metabolic products contained in non-mineralized and mineralized dental deposits. Second, factors of the oral cavity that can enhance or weaken the pathogenic potential of microorganisms and metabolic products. Third, general factors regulating the metabolism of tissue of the oral cavity, on which the response to pathogenic influence depends. Removal of non-mineralized and mineralized dental deposits is a significant part of the prevention and etiotropic therapy of inflammatory periodontal diseases and dental caries. Hygiene. This is a field of science, in particular medicine, which studies the influence of living conditions, labor on a person, and develops the prevention of various diseases. providing optimal conditions for existence, preserving health and prolonging life. Personal hygiene is a set of hygiene rules, the implementation of which contributes to the prevention and strengthening of health. Hygiene, along with sensation and epidemiology, is one of the areas of preventive medicine. Oral hygiene is a set of measures aimed at preventing and improving the oral cavity. Professional oral hygiene, a scientifically based system of preventive measures performed by a dentist, dental hygienist, aimed at improving the organs and tissues of the oral cavity and preventing the onset and progression of dental diseases. For the first time, professional clinic as a component of the program for the prevention of caries in inflammatory periodontal diseases was proposed by Axelson and Lindke at 1970. Professional hygiene. The purpose of professional oral hygiene is the prevention and treatment of diseases of the hard tissue of the teeth and oral mucosa. Professional oral hygiene is a scientifically based system of preventive measures carried out by a dentist, a hygienist, aimed at improving the organs and tissue of the oral cavity and preventing the onset and progression of the dental diseases. You need to understand that the professional cleaning is just a stage of professional hygiene. Don't confuse the two. Professional hygiene consists of a series of sequential activities that the dentist carries out together with the patient. Professional oral hygiene stages. First, conducting a sanitary and educational conversation or motivation. Second, individual selection of means and items for oral hygiene. Third, individual oral hygiene training. Fourth, professional teeth cleaning. Fifth, checking the brush and technique and then correcting it by a doctor or supervised brushing. Almost all of these stages are carried out as follows. First, the patient visits the doctor 4 times with an interval of 2 or 3 days. Then, the intervals between visits are increased to 15, 30, 60 days, depending on the hygienic state of the patient. At the first visit, doctor examines the oral cavity, registers the patient's outpainting card, the condition of his teeth and gums, assesses the state of oral hygiene using hygiene indicators, Fedor Volotkin, Green Vermilion, PHP, Kuznetsova, etc. In case of unsatisfactory oral hygiene, the doctor, in front of the mirror, demonstrates the dental deposits on his teeth to the patient using tools, excavator, flotator, and plug indicators, iodine solutions, erythrosine, fuchsin, dental tables, Dinal. Then doctors conducts a conversation with the patient about the role of plaque in the development of dental caries and periodontal disease. This stage is named motivation. After those cases, doctor conducts an individual selection of oral hygiene products and items, gives recommendation for oral care, time, duration, frequency of the teeth brushing, is the second stage of professional oral hygiene. Then doctor conducts training in brushing teeth. Then doctor performs the professional teeth cleaning with polishing of fillings and subsequent deep fluoridation. Professional dental cleaning is through removal of soft and hard dental plaque from all surfaces of the teeth and subsequent treatment of teeth and gums with prophylactic agents. Oral cavity preparation before removing dental deposits. Before the direct removal of dental plaque, the doctor prepares the oral cavity, which consists in irrigating the oral cavity with a weak antiseptic solution, chlorhexidine, carsodil, eluderil, furacilin, iatonium, miramistin, dimexidum, gexarol. Chlorhexidine, antiseptic and bacterial agent, active against gram-positive and gram-negative aerobic and anaerobic flora. Some viruses has a fungicidal effect. For treatment, the oral mucosa and rhinoses, a chlorhexidine solution at 1.02 solution is used. It is not recommended to use chlorhexidine for longer than 6-7 days. Long term, use the cause dysbacteriosis of the oral cavity and reversible coloration of the surface of the tongue, teeth, filling materials, and also cause a change in taste sensitivity, may cause allergic reaction. Furacilinum, antibacterial drug of the Nutrofuran series, has an effect on gram-positive and gram-negative flora. It is used in the form a 0.02% solution in the treatment of periodontics, gingivitis, including at the stage of abscess formation. The drug is used in the form of rinsing and irrigation of the oral cavity. Etonium. It has a bactericidal and bacteriostatic effect on streptococci and staphylococci. Of application on the mucous membrane of the gums, introduction into the periodontal pocket and antiseptic treatment of the oral mucosa at a 0.5% solution. Ointment in used. Miramistin. Solution of miramistin has a pronounced antimicrobial effect against gram-positive and gram-negative aerobic and anaerobic flora of the oral cavity, fungicidal, antiviral, and antiprotozoal action. It is used for rinsing the mouth. In terms of effectiveness, it is somewhat inferior to chlorhexidine. When using the drug, a burning sensation may appear with 10% 15 seconds, which does not require discontinuation of the drug. Dimexidum has antiseptic and non-specific anti-inflammatory effects, exhibits antiviral and anti-allergic activity. Solution is used for rinsing the mouth. An allergic reaction is possible. Professional dental cleaning. Methods for removing dental plaque divided on two groups. chemical and mechanical. Mechanical can be manual and hardware. Chemical method, removal of dental deposits. The chemical method is rarely used alone. It is usually used to press off the dental plaque before removing it with special tools. The chemical method is indicated in the presence of tightly attached dental plaque and teeth mobility. The active principle in solution or gels intended for the purpose can be organic acid or hydrochloric acid. There are drugs such as Detarspat, Tetatrol, Softening Gel, Belagel R. The preparations are applied to the surface of dental plaque for 30-60 seconds, then removed with a swab of washed off, and begin mechanical removal of dental calculus. Mechanical method removal of dental deposits. Hand tools for removing plaque. To remove dental deposits by hand, special tools are used: scalers, curettes, excavators, chisels, rasps. Hand tool, according to the material from which they are made, are metallic, metallic diamond coated, plastic, Teflon. Plastic and Teflon instruments are used for the removal of soft dental plaque and professional oral hygiene in children. Plastic and Teflon dental scalers may resemble traditional metal scalers, but most often the working end is adapted to the shape and size of the implants. Diamond-coated tools are most often used for patchworks. They have a curved shoulder, a rounded working part, and are used to process the root furcation zone. The working part can be different in size. Almost all tools have the same design principle. All tools can be divided into three main elements. First, working part or shank. Second, shoulder. Third, handle. The handle should be comfortably gripped with your fingers so that you can guide the tool without getting tired and clearly control all movements. It should not be too thin or too heavy. The handle must be perfectly centered and designed and contoured to prevent rotation and slipping of the tool during operation. With a balanced tool, the working end is within 2 mm of the longitudinal axis of the tool. The correct balance is essential to ensure maximum cutting performance of the instrument with minimal stress of the clinical's hand. Handles can be one- and double-sided, different in relief, diameter, and material from which they are made. There are many types of instrument grips that differ in shape and style. When choosing a handle, you should pay special attention to weight, diameter, and the relief of the handle. Exist traditional filled metal handles, hollow inside metal handles, and silicone-coated handles. Lighter handles should be preferred. Hollow metal handles and silicone-coated handles improve tactile sensation and reduce hand strain during work. The tool shaft can be flexible, medium flexibility, tough and very tough. The choice of the stiffness of the rod and therefore the arm of the instrument depends on the purpose of the procedure. Flexible rods are used for application requiring maximum tactile sensation, such as detecting plaque and removing small amounts of calculus. For example, Gracie curettes have a flexible shaft. General purpose curettes usually have a medium flexibility shaft, which provides a good tactile sensation and the ability to remove small to medium amounts of dental plaque. Hard chunk instruments are designed to remove massive dental deposits. Tactical sensitivity when using such instruments is reduced. Crescents, scalers, rasps, hoes, curettes with the rigid marking have a rigid rod. And finally, the extra rigid rod. It is used for work where tactical sensitivity is not required and in the presence of dense massive dental deposits. Such a rod is found in the Grace curette, which is marked extra rigid. And finally, the extra rigid rod. It is used for work where tactical sensitivity is not required and in the presence of dense massive dental deposits. Such a rod is found in the Grace curette, which is marked extra rigid. And finally, the actual working part or shank, which determines the type of tool. It has an end, a back, and two sides. Sharp edges pass between the end face and the sides, which are used for processing. Depending on the shape of the working part, there are scalers and curettes. Scalers. The working part of the scaler is pointed and has a triangular shape in cross section. The butt is at 90 angle to the shoulder. This form makes it possible to remove supragingival dental deposits without injuring the gums. The tool has two identical size cutting edges, which makes it versatile. This instrument is well suited for cleaning interdental areas. Scalers have different bands and different shapes of the working part. They range from simple tools designed for the removal of massive dental deposits to sophisticated tools for delicate work. Crescent scalers have two cutting edges and a sharp tip, designed to remove supragingival plaque and calculus, effective for removing dental plaque from the proximal surfaces. Scalers can be straight or curved. The working part of straight sickle scales is straight and at right angles to the handle. These scalers are designed to remove dental plaque in the air of the anterior teeth. Curved crescent scalers have a crescent-shaped working and at an angle to the tooth handle. The working part of the sickle-shaped scalers exists the mini modification. Scalers mini are designed to remove minor dental deposits from the interdental spaces and are also used for flap operation. Hoes scalers, hoes, are bent in a plane relative to the tool handle at an angle of about 100. The hoes have one cutting edge, sharpened at an angle of 45. This shape of the hook prevents trauma to the bottom of the periodontal pocket. Curettes. The working part of the curette has a semicircular cross section, a rounded back, and apex. This form makes it possible to remove subgingival dental deposits without injuring the gums. Curettes are distinguished special and versatile. The universal ones have two identical cutting edges and are designed to work on all root surfaces. Special curettes have only one cutting edge and are designed to work either on the distal or mesial surface of the tooth. Universal curettes have two cutting edges and a rounded tip. The angle between the axis of the rod and the blade is 90. They are used both on the medial and on the distal surfaces of the tooth without changing the instrument. Universal curettes can be used to remove supragingival dental plaque, especially in the cervical region, and for curettage. Available for front teeth and back teeth. Gracie curettes. In curette Gracie, the working part is sharpened only on one side and has one cutting edge. The angle between the axis of the rod and the blade is 70. This allows the instrument to be positioned correctly at the bottom of the periodontal pocket, where view is impossible. Curette Gracie have a mark on the handle of the instrument, which indicates which surface of which tooth it is intended for. There are also special color charts for Gracie curettes. In curette Gracies, the tooth color of the cut matches the color of the tool handle marking. For example, mark 1-2 for the vestibular surface of the incisors and canines. Mark 9-10 for vestibular and oral surfaces of molars and hard to reach areas of the root surface, etc. Gracie curettes can be used as finishing curettes to effectively smooth root cement. The Gracie Pro curettes are available with a shorter and stiffer tip for supragingival work. Gracie curettes extra hard is to remove massive supragingival dental plaque. Curettes Gracie after 5 for access to deep periodontal pockets. The shaft of these curettes is 3 mm longer than that of standard curettes. The thin blade facilitates penetration into the periodontal pocket and minimizes trauma of the gum. The design of the working part is fully consistent with the main Gracie curettes. Curette Gracie Mini 5 for working in narrow, deep pockets of mainly anterior teeth. The working part is 3 mm longer, which always penetration into pocket more than 5 mm deep. The blade length is half that of standard Gracie and after 5. The working part fully corresponds to the main Gracie curettes. Langer curettes. Langers combines the features of universal curettes and Gracie curettes working part shape. They are used both on the medial and on the distal surface of the tooth without changing the instrument. Available from front teeth and lateral teeth. There are also Langers after 5, mini 5, and rigid. Curtains. zone-specific curettes designed to work effectively on a specific tooth surface, available for anterior and posterior teeth, palatine, lingual and vestibular surfaces. The shape of the working part perfectly matched to the anatomy of the crown part of the tooth. In addition to effective removal of dental plaque, they are characterized by minimal trauma to soft tissue, which significantly improves health. Finishing curettes are used to smooth root and remove plaque in deep pockets. Incisional edge position at an ideal 70 angle to the tooth surface for efficient work. Thanks to this angle, only one edge of the curette is working. Modification torsion. The shape of the blade on the cut differs from the standard gracing by the presence of an acute angle, which makes the blade thinner and facilitates access to deep periodontal pockets. The blade is either too sharpened. Courbet's vision. The instrument is called the courbet because it has a curved blade from curve, which resembles the working part of a scalar. The working part is 50% shorter than the gracing curette for working in deep and narrow periodontal pockets, marking 5 mm and 10 mm on the working part. Curtains, furcation curettes. For work in the field of root furcation, there are buccal and medial distal, working part wide about 1 mm. There are entire sets of hand tools designed to remove plaque from all surfaces of teeth. For example, McCall has 7 basic instruments, Goldman Fox 6 basic instruments, Cattoni, McFarlane, DeMarco, Quatin, etc. Rasp has multiply cutting edges on one base and is designed to remove extensive dental plaque by scraping them from the surface of the teeth. The base can be round or oval. The lower part of the base is rounded for use with a file in the subgingival area. The working part of the rasp is located at an angle of 90 in relation to the handle. However, the rasp is difficult to adapt to uneven tooth surfaces and has limited tactical sensation. Chisels, used to remove dental calculus from the proximal surface of the teeth. The chisels has a straight or slightly curved shoulder and one cutting edge, sharpened at an angle of 45. Dental excavators, used to remove massive dental plaque from the vestibular, buccal and oral surfaces of the teeth. Excavators can have a work section of various size, 1 mm, 1.2, 1.5, 2 mm, 3.5 mm. In addition, according to the number of shoulder bends, they are 1, 2 and 3 cornered. Method of work with mechanical manual instrument. Tools for removing plaque should be sharp, which ensures the successful removal of dental plaque, reduce the risk of damage to the gingival margin, reduce fatigue, and increases the tactical sensitivity of the doctor. During the procedure for removing tartar, parts of it may get into the doctor's eyes. For protection, You must use special glasses and masks. To remove dental plaque, you need to choose a tool that matches the shape of its working part as closely as possible to the features, crown, neck, tooth root, and providing a snug fit of the tool edge to the surface. This is especially important when processing the surface of the root of teeth because the instrument is inserted into the periodontal pocket. The procedure requires good lighting, which is provided by the dental unit lamp and sometimes by the light reflected from the dental mirror. To create a view and protect the oral mucosa, a dental mirror is used, with which the patient's cheek is pushed back. The vacuum cleaner and salve ejector must be used. There are five main stages of work with hand tools: gripping the tool, tool location, setting the angle, activation, directly work. The first step is to grip the tool. The position of the instrument in the hand may vary, like a fountain pen, a middle finger rest. This grip provides the best control over tool movements. Grip for working on the teeth of the upper jaw with a thumb rest. The hand holding the instrument should be fixed on the patient's chin or adjacent teeth. The movable teeth are held with the fingers of the left hand. Step 3. Setting the angle. The angle between the tip of the tooth and the surface of the tooth should be approximately 70. Depending on the surface of the tooth, the angle of inclination of the cutting surface of the tool can vary from 45 to 90. When working with tooth cement, the angle decreases average of 60 and the pressure force on the root surface decreases. Fourth stage, activation. The working part of the instrument is brought under the lower edge of the calculus and chipped off from the tooth surface. Movements should be smooth, not dramatic, level-like cleaving. There are two options of the working with hand tools for removing dental plaque. First, with a brush. With this type of work, the main movement and the main load fall on the wrist and partly on the elbow joint. This option is used when removing massive dental deposits. Second, with your fingers. This way of working is based on the strength of the doctor's fingers. It is mainly used for delicate work requiring good tactical sensation and for working of the vestibular and lingual surface of the teeth. The basic principles of removing dental plaque with hand tools: consistency, sequence, the use of overlapping movements, constant control. It is recommended to start removing plaque from the distal surface of 3.8 tooth and move medially to remove plaque from the vestibular side of the molars and premolars. Next, the lingual surface of this teeth is treated. In the same sequence, calculus is removed from the lateral teeth of the right half of the lower jaw. After that, they proceed to cleaning the front group of teeth, starting from the lingual surface of the 3.3 tooth, sequentially processing the lingual surface of the front teeth than the vestibular. It is advisable to clean one and the same surface of several teeth with one instrument and then change the instrument. Instrument movements can be vertical, horizontal, and diagonal. Vertical movements are commonly used to remove plaque from the proximal surface of the teeth. Oblique on the lingual and vestibular surfaces, and horizontal in the presence of pronounced periodontal pockets. For complete cleaning of the tooth surface, horizontal movements must be performed first clockwise and then counterclockwise. The presence of deep pockets, the root surface is also treated with oblique movements of the curette along the root surface. It is recommended to treat the root surface with several successive strokes with low pressure, which is less traumatic for the root surface. To remove calculus from the proximal surface of the teeth, either small side floats of a scale chisel are used. The instrument is pushed with little effort from the vestibular surface to the lingual surface along the edge of the tooth, chipping off the tartar. When working with scalers on the vestibular surfaces of the central incisors, the tartar is removed from the neck of the tooth with a gradual turn of the cutting edge of the instrument from the neck to the interdental space. Dental excavators are used to remove calculus from the lingual vestibular surfaces of the teeth, as well as to treat the root surface. The excavator performs sharing movements, while the hand makes a turn with the tool at angle of up to 90 degrees. Electrical tools for removal of dental deposits. Classification of electric scale removal instruments. Ultrasonic can be magnetostrictive and piezoelectric, sound and powder blasting machines. Ultrasonic removal of dental plaque. These mechanisms allow removing dental deposits not only in the contact zone with the tip, but also at a short distance from it. However, the presence of cavitation and acoustic turbulence mechanisms has been proven only in vitro studies. Ultrasonic scaling is based on a combination of four different mechanisms: mechanical processing, irrigation, cavitation, acoustic turbulence. Ultrasonic instruments for removing dental plaque operate a frequency of 16 to 45 kHz. The frequency of operation of piezoelectric instruments is from 25 to 45 kHz and magnetostrictive from 16 to 42 kHz. Ultrasonic scalers are more powerful than sonic scalers. The most powerful ultrasonic devices are piezoelectric devices. Magnetostrictive scalers. Magnetostrictive scalers are made of a ferromagnetic metal tube in a high-frequency magnetic field. The magnetic field causes the tube to expand and contact, which causes the tip to vibrate. Throughout the operation, a system of water is passed through the handpiece to the tooth to prevent heating of the cleaned surface. The appearance of the cavitation effect is also associated with water, which is absorbed when ultrasonic propagates in a liquid medium. The effect of cavitation is the formation of pulsating bubbles filled with steam, gas, or their mixture. Cavitation bubbles pulsate, merge, giving rise to strong hydrodynamic disturbances in the liquid, microflows, erosion of the surface of solids, boiling of the cavitating liquid. The attachment of magnetostreactive scalars generate elliptical and circular oscillatory movements. This allows all surfaces of the attachment to be used. The attachment of magnetostreactive scalars heats up quickly and significantly, so a large amount of water is required during operation. The property of magnetostreactive scalars makes it possible to somewhat reduce the patient's pain sensation if he has sensitivity of the neck or the teeth to cold. Main magnetostreactive scalars are Parkel, Dentsply, Cavitron, Odontostone M, Denmark. Piezoelectric scalars. The piezoelectric effect is a phenomenon in samples of some anisotropic materials and consists in violation of the equilibrium distribution of electric changes under the action of mechanical deformation of the sample. The piezoelectric instruments, high-frequency vibration of produced by a quartz crystal. These tools use a small amount of water. Piezoelectric scalars. When working with piezoelectric scalars, vibration propagates in the longitudinal direction. The vibration amplitude range from 6 to 100. With this movement, only two sides of the nozzle are activated. This complicates the work. However, it is believed that piezoelectric scalars are less damaging than magnetostreactive and sonic ones. Basic piezoelectric scales are scalars from EMS, Amdent, Beatrol, Satellec, Siroson. Sonic removal of dental plaque. Sound instruments also have a rod that vibrates when exposed to compressed air. The vibration frequency is from 2 to 6 kHz. The vibration amplitude is up to 1.5 mm. Sonic scalars create elliptical oscillatory movement, the radius of which decreased with increasing procedure of the surface to the cleaned. With such vibration, all sides of the nozzle are active. The maximum vibration without a noticeable movement of the tip are made at a pressure of no more than 80 grams on the surface to be cleaned. The power of these tools increased when pressed on the instrument, and at the same time, the unpleasant sensation of vibration in the patient increased. Most often, sonic scalars are available as a tip for dental unit turbine connectors. One of the significant disadvantages of electric scalars is the presence of a large number of contraindications for their use. Implanted Parkinmaker, localized osteomyelitis, malignant neoplasms, carrying out immunosuppressive and cardiosteroid therapy in patients, violation of nasal breathing, acute or chronic infection diseases, sever from a diabetes mellitus, epilepsy, defects of soft tissue of the oral cavity, children with the milk teeth or newly erupted permanent teeth. When removing dental deposits, water cooling is required to avoid thermal damage of the tooth pulp. An in vitro study revealed that without water cooling, it is possible to heat the dental hard tissue up to 200. In modern electric scalers, sterile antiseptic solution can be used instead of water to cool the nozzle and irrigate the treated surface. When working with a scaler, it is necessary to protect patient's eyes with glasses to warn him about breathing through his nose. The doctor and the assistant should observe the rules of asepsis, work with glasses, gloves, masks. The tip of the scaler is easily gripped between thumb and forefinger. The doctor's hand should be fixed on the patient's chin or dentition. Moving teeth must not be used for support. The tip of the tool should be positioned along and at an acute angle to the work surface. Otherwise, beating movements appear unpleasant and painful for the patient, as well as damage to the enamel and spalling of fillings. The movement of the tip should be like a brush with light lateral pressure. It is impossible to work continuously in one place. The tooth surface should be processed intermittently, taking into account the thermal effect of the scale of the tooth pulp. The addition ultrasonic has the ability to disrupt the adhesion of fillings to the tooth tissue during prolonged exposure. So, when removing dental deposits, the movement of the instrument must not be allowed to stop at one point, especially if there is a filling on the tooth. The contact of the working part of the tool and the work surface must be maintained constantly. It is desirable to perform the so-called overlapping movement in different directions, which will ensure the most complete removal of dental plaque. When working, the doctor should avoid areas of decalcification, caries, erosion, increased wear, the margins of the restoration, artificial crowns, orthodontic structures and system and implants. It is also necessary to avoid contact of the oral mucosa with the tip of ultrasonic and sound device due to the risk of damage. Excess fluid is removed by an assistant using a salve ejector and vacuum cleaner. When removing plaque from the anterior group of teeth, vacuuming prevents liquid from entering the patient's nose and also protects the mucous membrane of the lip. When processing the remaining areas, the vacuum cleaner is placed on the working area with a scalar nozzle, so that the liquid is removed from the oral cavity and not directly from the nozzle. Advantages of electric scalers: cleaning the operating field with water, reduction of the doctor's work time, less effort of the part of the doctor, more comfortable for the patient. The main disadvantages of scalers: the existence of contraindication and complication when using the technique of ultrasonic removal of dental calculus. Decrease in technical sensitivity during manipulation. Deterioration of visibility due to splashes. Possible damage to surfaces and pulp of the tooth and soft tissue of the oral cavity due to errors in the use of equipment. Powder blasting machines. To remove plaque, you can use special powder blasting machine. air abrasive system. This device uses abrasive powder. Most often it is sodium bicarbonate or aluminium oxide. Contraindication for the use of powder blasting machines. The need for a sodium-free diet. Taking medication that affects salt metabolism. Diseases of the upper respiratory tract. Infectious diseases. Pregnancy. The main powder blasting machine, Airflow and CoverProfiFlex. The procedure is accompanied by the formation of an aerosol coat, which requires the protection of the eyes of the patient and medical personnel with special glasses. The distance between the tip and the tooth should be 3-5 mm. The ideal angle between the tip and the tooth surface is 30-60 degrees. When working, the nozzle should be directed to the tooth, the movements should be circular. A jet of mixture of water, air and powder strikes. The surface of the tooth is reflected from it and it cooled by a doctor assistant using a vacuum cleaner. It is not recommended to use powder blasting machine on the surface of exposed root or dental and composite fillings. Gridding and polishing. Regardless of the method of removing dental plaque, this procedure ends with grinding and polishing the teeth. Grinding the treated tooth surface removes microagnosis. During polishing, the surface is perfectly smooth, which further reduces the risk of calculus and plaque retention. To carry out this procedure, use special circular brushes, soft rubber heads, drills fixed in the contra-angle handpiece. The rotation speed of the polishing tools is 2000. Brushes are produced with natural and artificial bristles. Natural brushes are softer and darker in color. It is preferable to use artificial ones. Distinguish in form: round, cylindrical, and conical. In the area of the interdental spaces, polishing of the tooth tissue can be carried out using polishing strips of varying degrees of abrasiveness, starting with coarse strips and moving on to softer ones. There are polymer, metal, and diamond-coated stripes. Abrasiveness is indicated by color: rough, medium, fine-grained, ultra-fine-grained. In addition, special polishing paste are used. It is desirable that they contain fluoride preparation for remineralization of the treated dental tissue and weak antiseptic agents. The composition of this paste is close to the composition of paste for individual oral care. However, they are more abrasive. Pumice silicate or aluminum oxide, silicon dioxide, zircon are used as abrasive fill. Polishing begins with a coarse polishing paste with a rubber cup, then processing with a medium grain paste due to which the univeness formed by the previous paste is smooth. Only in the order of alternation of polishing paste is observed can a smoothly polished surface be obtained. And finally, the final polishing is carried out with a fine-grained fluorine-contained paste. Second visit. At the second visit, the patient comes with a new toothbrush and toothpaste recommended by the doctor. Teeth cleaning and hygiene indicate are checked. If necessary, the teeth cleaning technique is correct. The doctor on the model using a toothbrush and then in the patient's oral cavity demonstrates the method of brushing teeth, teaches the use of toothpicks and floss. If necessary, the final removal of plaque and calculus is carried out in adults and children. Grinding and polishing of necks and accessible areas of tooth roots. On the second visit, remineralizing therapy is carried out with the use of calcium and fluorine-containing agents, specific and deep fluoridation. On the third visit, the effectiveness of the improved brushing technique is monitored. The doctor monitors the quality of tooth cleaning using plaque indicators. On the same visit, the dentist or hygienist polishes fillings, performs preventive products, checks occlusion, and selective reshapes all teeth. For children, according to indication, fissure sealing is performed. For adult patients, strictly according to indication, therapeutic and prophylactic measures are carried out. Teeth whitening, treatment of hyperesthesia or hard dental tissues. On the fourth visit, if necessary, subsequent visits, the oral hygiene is monitored and corrected. At each visit by a doctor or a specially trained assistant, a thorough removal of plaque and tartar is carried out, especially from hard to reach surfaces of the teeth, until the oral cavity is in an ideal hygienic state, which the patient must maintain himself in the future. Features of professional oral hygiene depending on the age and dental status of the patient. Professional oral hygiene should be carried out 2 times a year, followed by a dental fluoridation or remineralizing therapy. More often, it is recommended to carry out this procedure for patients with bad habits, such as smoking, or for patients with individual characteristics of the salivary glands, which secrete many minerals into salivary, thus predisposing to increased formation of hard dental deposits. Particular attention is paid to children in the period of mixed bite from 7 to 9 years old. If children have dental alveolar anomalies, individual training in oral hygiene is necessary. Patients with periodontitis in the stage of decompensation, professional hygiene should be carried out according to the schedule, removing the acute phase. Thank you for the attention.